Thank you, Vice Mayor. To the point about moving, helping provide the assistance and incentive for Mark to move from downtown, regardless of which proposal we choose, and at the moment, Third Rock is the proposal of choice at the moment, you know, depending on how we ask them to sharpen their pencils any further, but we've already started the discussions about seeing providing a reasonable location for them, should they be chosen, again, right next to the sanitary landfill, but not on city property, since city property requires competitive bidding and all the work that needs to go through that. So working in conjunction with our downtown business leaders, who have also expressed a strong opinion as yourself about cleaning up the Renaissance area and making it something much more, we'll continue along that line. And as I know this was just given to you today, but if you look at the long term under option two, it does say, upon completion of the initial contract, the city of Fort Smith will retain ownership of the single stream sort equipment, and Third Rock Recycling will retain ownership of the facility and remaining support equipment. So that is the direction, you know, we wanted, we know what the board wants. It's the same thing, of course, that we want, but following all of the discussions we've had, that's the goal, and also making sure, as it has always been, that it does remain cost neutral to the citizens of Fort Smith. And we now have that opportunity not to just make it cost neutral, but actually to generate revenue over the term of the 3-year contract.
Director Good. Thank you, Vice Mayor. I appreciate the comments from fellow board members and Carl. Jeff, thank you for your explanation. And I won't make this long about Mark, because it seems as though we're already leaning towards Third Rock, but in reference to the Second Street location, which is in my ward, even temporarily, I would be concerned about using Mark to use that facility, even if we stress it in the importance of parameters of vehicles, how it's being maintained, and how the move takes place. I don't want to leave that in someone else's hands, out of our control. You know, I don't want to have to continue to deal with the situation we dealt with over the years of looking at that eyesore downtown, and it being another eyesore, especially with the development and talk we just had in January with the master plan group about, you know, closing some of the one-way streets and doing more development through that area on those corridors. So I won't make a long story about that, but I'm not interested even in the short term. And even with that short term, my other concern, and this is about Mark, is what Keith just asked about the cost. You know, I would hate, and I've seen this happen, we've all seen it happen, unexpected fees or amounts that we're stuck with. Yeah, can't see that happening either, especially if we're talking about keeping this cost neutral to our citizens.
I would like to comment. I had constructive discussions the last several days with representatives from Mark Industries about the facility, about this particular interest. And as I mentioned when I started, they certainly understand that interest that the city has. Just north of the, of course, closer to the museums could be, and that sort of thing. I did ask them to provide some photographs, which I included in the slides, of some of their other facilities, and you can see that they don't store materials outside typically. As I mentioned earlier, they acquired this property in August and have done some considerable work to clean up the property. They had a hiatus there when the equipment on the property broke down. They had to do some significant investment to get it to work again, and are now, as I understand, back in the business of being able to consolidate that material and get it out of there. The property does look considerably better than it did. I mean, even in the short amount that they've been able to do, it does. It looks better than it did. And my understanding, they are property owner, they own the property, It's a representative that it is representative of their company now, and I do believe that we have the commitment of them to go ahead and finish that cleanup process, because that's not the type of facility that they operate. So I just wanted to make that clear that I think that they do intend to have that facility on Second Street look similar to these. I mean, it's an industrial property. I mean, that's what it is, but it shouldn't look like the trash. And I think that they are committed to solving that.